Let us start next sum in liquidation. A Limited went into voluntary liquidation on 31st 3 2020, and they are given a balance sheet. First we'll go through liabilities. 4000 6% preference share of 100 each fully paid up, and 2000 equity share of 100 each 75 rupees as paid up, and 6000 equity share of 100 each 60 rupees as paid up. Okay, here 75 rupees has paid up for 2000 equity share, and for 6000 equity share 60 rupees has paid up. Two kinds of equity share are there. Okay, 5% debentures. Next, interest outstanding on debenture and creditors is mentioned. Next, land and building, plant and machinery, stock, patents, debtors, cash in and P&L account has been there in asset side. Okay, the preference dividend were in arrears for 2 years. Preference share capital is 4 lakh and preference dividend is 6% on this 4 lakh for an year. It has been due for how many years? 2 years. Okay. Next, creditors include a loan of 1 lakh for mortgage on land and buildings. This creditor of 2 lakh 90,000 include 1 lakh which is secured, include 1 lakh which is secured against land and building. That means it is secured loan. Okay, if land and building is sold, first we have to pay for whom? Secure creditors. How much it, the secure creditor worth? 1 lakh. Okay, next, asset realized, land and building, plant and machinery, patent, stock, debtors. Next, liquidation expenses amounted to 21,800 and liquidator commission is 3% on asset realized except cash. Any asset realized, we will pay how many percent? 3% other than cash, and he also get 2% on amount paid to unsecured creditors and preferential creditor. Amount paid to unsecured creditor and preferential creditor. We will not give commission on secured creditor. We will give only commission on whom? Unsecured creditor and preferential creditor. Let us solve this sum. Liquidator final statement of account. First receipt side, amount. Payment side, amount. Always start with cash in hand. Since it is a liquid asset, we cannot sell the asset because it is already in liquid form. Cash at bank is there. How much? 60,000. Cash at bank, 60,000. Okay. Then we will write asset realize. In question, asset realize has been mentioned. Asset realize. Land and building, how much? 2,40,000. But we must know that land and building is secured asset and it is secured against creditor. It is secured against creditor. So we will write remaining asset. Debtors, how much? 1,60,000. We are realizing debtors for 1,60,000. Stock, 1,20,000. Patents, 60,000. Plant and machineries, 4 lakh. Except secure creditor, we wrote all the asset realized. $1,60,000 + $1,20,000 + $60,000 + $4,00,000 total would amount to $7,40,000. And let us write surplus on secured asset. Okay, how much we are realizing from land and building? From land and building we are realizing 2,40,000. From land and building we are realizing 2,40,000, but it is secured against the loan. But it is secured against the loan for 1 lakh. Loan we have to pay is 1 lakh. By realizing this asset, we need to pay for secured creditor 1 lakh. What is the remaining amount? Remaining amount will be 1,40,000. After paying to secure creditor, what is the amount remaining is 1,40,000. Okay. here is the completion of receipt side. What is the total money we have for paying liability? 7,40,000 plus initially 60,000 cash at bank plus 1,40,000. Totally we have 9,40,000 to pay off our liability. 9,40,000. Okay. Next, liquidation expenses. Payment side, first one we need to pay is liquidation expenses or legal charges. How much is liquidation expenses? 21,800. Liquidation expenses 21,800. After liquidation expenses, we need to pay for liquidator commission. Okay, liquidator is getting a two kinds of commission. First one is on 3% on asset realized. 3% on asset realized except cash. Except cash, we have to pay 3% on any asset realized. What is the total asset we realized is 9,40,000 including cash minus cash at bank 60,000. If we deduct 60,000 except cash, we realized how much? 8,80,000. I am repeating once again, total cash which we realized including cash at bank is 9,40,000. If you deduct this 60,000, if you deduct this 60,000 cash at bank means we will get asset realized except cash at bank. What is that amount? That amount will amount to 8,80,000. 8,80,000. On this 8,80,000, we have to pay a commission of 3%. So he will get a commission of 26,400. He is getting a commission of 26,400. Next, what is the second type of commission he is getting? On payment, 2% of amount paid to unsecured creditor and preferential creditor. First, we need to pay to these guys. Afterwards, we have to realize whether sufficient fund is there or not. Okay. By seeing this, we can say sufficient fund is there. Okay. Because total cash we have is 9,40,000. 9,40,000 we already paid what? Liquidator remuneration, sorry, liquidation expenses 12,000 and liquidator remuneration. After that, we have to pay to debenture 2,00,000. I think sufficient fund is there. Sufficient fund is there. Okay. Let us pay one by one. Remuneration after paying to unsecured creditor. Okay. It will be there. Debenture. What is the amount of debenture? 2,00,000. And outstanding interest 10,000. Total 2,10,000. Debenture holders. Capital 2,00,000. And interest outstanding is 10,000. Total we need to pay 2,10,000. Okay. After debenture holders, we need to pay for whom? Unsecured creditor. Let us understand what is the payment we have made to unsecured creditor. Total creditor would amount to 2,90,000. Total creditor would amount to 2,90,000. In this 2,90,000, we know we already paid to secured creditor for rupees 1,00,000. We already paid to secured creditor of rupees 1,00,000. Okay. Unsecured creditors. Total creditors would amount to 2,90,000. In this 2,90,000, we already paid to secured creditor how many? 1,00,000. What is the remaining amount? 1,90,000. And this 1,90,000, we will treat it as unsecured creditor. No bifurcation as given for preferential creditor. So we will treat it unsecured creditor and preferential creditor, or both are included in this amount. What is the total amount of unsecured creditor? Is 2,90,000. We need to pay, what is the total amount of unsecured creditor? 1,90,000. We need to pay to unsecured creditor so much, 1,90,000. How this 1,90,000 came? Total creditor 2,90,000. From this secure creditor 1,00,000. If you deduct 1,00,000, means what is the remaining amount? 1,90,000. It is treated as what? Unsecured creditor. On the unsecured creditor, we need to pay a commission of 3%. 3% would amount to how much? 3,800. Previously, we paid an interest of 26,400 plus 3,800. Total commission would amount to 30,200. Okay. After paying to unsecured creditor, we need to pay preference shareholder. Okay. What is the amount of preference share capital due? 4,00,000. And they also mentioned preference dividend for arrears for how many years? 2 years. Capital 4 lakh. Dividend 4 lakh capital. What is the rate of dividend we are paying? 6% into 6% means 24,000 for 1 year, and it is due for 2 years. It means it would amount to 48,000. Okay, 48,000 plus 4 lakh would comes to 4,48,000. Next, we have to pay to equity shareholder before paying 80,000. After paying to this secure creditor, we have a total cash of 9,40,000. From this 9,40,000, we already paid liquidation expenses of 9,40,000 minus liquidation expenses of 21,800 minus we paid liquidator remuneration of 30,200 minus we paid a debenture holder of 2,10,000 minus we paid to unsecured creditor 1,90,000. Next, we paid to preference shareholder 4,48,000. 4 lakh minus 4,48,000. Okay, what is the amount left with us? The amount left with us is 40,000. The amount left with us is 40,000. Okay. What is the amount remaining with us is 40,000. The amount remaining with us is 40,000. From this 40,000, we need to pay two equity shareholders. Okay, let us see equity shareholders. From seeing this, we can see that there is no single type of equity shareholder, but there are two kind of equity shareholders. First equity shareholder have 2,000. First kind of equity shareholder is they paid up 75 rupees. They paid up how much? 75 rupees. 2,000 equity share of 100 rupees, they paid 75 rupees. Second kind is 6,000 equity share, they paid how many rupees? 60 rupees. Okay, and we need to distribute this 40,000 between these two guys, between the two guys, so that we should distribute it in that manner that each shareholder will suffer same loss. Now yatra distribute madbekandre eldu shareholder gu enagbeku same loss suffer agbeku. So we can move to calculation. First equity share 2000 into 75, total equity share is 1,50,000, and second equity share 6000 into 60 rupees, total equity share total capital equity share share capital generated is 3,60,000. If you add two things, means you will get a total equity share capital of 5,10,000. 5,10,000. Okay, total equity share capital of 5,10,000. How this 5,10,000 came? 1,50,75 paid off, 3,60,60 paid off. Okay, 5,10,000. What is the amount available with us to pay this guy? The amount available with us to pay these guys is 40,000. Okay, that means what is the total loss that equity shareholder need to suffer is 4,70,000. Equity shareholder need to suffer a loss of 4,70,000. Okay, how many equity share are there? 8,000 equity share is there. How many equity shares is there? 8,000. First 2,000 equity share 75 paid off, next 6,000 equity share 60 paid off. What is the total number of equity share? 8,000. This 4,70,000 loss must be borne by this equity shareholder divided by 8,000. That means each shareholder will suffer a loss of 58.75 rupees. It is loss. We are talking about what loss? Each shareholder must suffer a loss of 58.75 rupees. Okay, then once again come to question. First equity share, 2,000 equity shareholder has paid how many rupees? 75 rupees. They already paid how many rupees? 75 rupees. And they must suffer a loss of how many rupees? 58 58.75 rupees. 58.75 rupees. 58.75 rupees loss need to be suffered by them. They paid how many rupees? 75 rupees. That means they are getting back how many rupees? 16 rupees. For first equity shareholder, we are paying 16.25 rupees for each equity share. For each equity share, into how many equity share are there? 2000. Okay. For second kind of equity shareholder, how many rupees has been paid up? 60 rupees has been paid up. How many rupees has been paid up? 60 rupees. And loss suffered by each equity share is 58.75. 60 rupees is paid up minus 58.75 is the loss suffered by each equity shareholder. That means they are getting how many rupees? 1.25. So they are getting how many rupees? 1.25. Okay. That means equity shareholders, first 2000 equity share will get how many rupees? What is the remaining balance? 16.25. okay. Next 6000 equity shareholder will get 1.25 rupees. 1.25 into 6000, they will get 7000 rupees. Next 16.25 into 2000, they will get how much? 32500. Into 6000, 1.25 into 6000 means they are getting 7500. 7500 plus 32500, total would amount to 40000. Total it would amount to 40000. I am repeating once again, the equity shareholder will get how many thousand? Only 40000. This 40000 cannot be distributed simply because in first kind of equity shareholders, they paid up only how many rupees? 75 rupees. And in second kind of equity shareholder, they paid up how many rupees? 60 rupees. So they cannot distribute this 4000 between the share in a equal ratio. Okay, so we wrote, what is the total amount of share? 150000 plus 360000, total it amount to 510000. What is the amount available with us? 40,000. If you deduct 40,000, means what is the loss suffered by the equity shareholder? 4,70,000. Okay, 4,70,000 divided by how many shares are there? 8,000. Divided by 8,000 share means each shareholder is suffering a loss of how much? 58.75 rupees. 58.75 rupees. That means first equity shareholder has paid 75 rupees minus 58.75 means they are getting how many rupees? 16.25 rupees. And second equity shareholders, 60 rupees has been paid up minus the loss offer is 58.75 rupees. What they are getting? 1.25 rupees. Okay, if we distribute in that order, means 2000 into 16.25 means you are we are paying 32000 for first kind of equity shareholders, and 6000 into 2.5 rupees means we are paying 7500 for second kind of equity share. Totally we are distributing 40000. okay, if we add all this, you will get 1 lakh. ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸತಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅವ್ರು ಏನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ? ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಓದ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ. ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ? ಪ್ರಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ 2 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಡ್ಯೂ ಇದೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಕಮಿಷನ್ 2 ತರ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕಂತೆ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ 3% ಆನ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕಂತೆ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್, ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೊಡಂಗಿಲ್ವಂತೆ, ಬೇರೆ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕಂತೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 2% ಆನ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಪೇ ಟು ಅನ್ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಿಫರೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್ 1/1, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ 1/1 ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಂದ್ವಿ. ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಇನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್, ಅದು ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಎಷ್ಟು ಇರುತ್ತೆ? 60,000 ಅಂತ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವಿ. ಅಸೆಟ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದಾರಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವಿ 1/1. ಟೋಟಲ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಂತು? 4,40,000 ಬಂತು, ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್. ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ 2,40,000 ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರ್ ಆಗಿರೋದು ಎಷ್ಟು? 1 ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಗೆ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. 1 ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ನ ಮೈನಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ, ಲೋನ್ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು 1 ಲ್ಯಾಕ್, 1 ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ನ ಮೈನಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರುತ್ತೆ? 1,40,000. ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸರಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ನೋಡಿ, ನಮಗೆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಲೋನ್ ಇತ್ತು. ಎಷ್ಟಿತ್ತು ಲೋನು? 1 ಲ್ಯಾಕ್. ಅದು ಪೇ ಏನು ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಎಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದು? 2,40,000ಗೆ. ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು? ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು. ಅದು ಡಿಡಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ? 1,40,000 ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಟೋಟಲ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಸೆಟ್ಟು ಸೇಲ್ ಆಗಿರೋದು ಎಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ನಮಗೆ? 1 ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ 40,000 ಸೇಲ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಇದರ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ 1 ಬೈ 1 ಪೇ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದ್ವಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡೇಷನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪೇ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದ್ವಿ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಬಂತು ಇಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಇಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಮಿಕ್ಕಿತ್ತು 40,000 ಮಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಮಿಕ್ಕಿತ್ತು 40,000 ಹಂಗೆ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಅದು 40,000 ಹೆಂಗೆ ನಾವು ಪೇ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ಗೂ ಸೇಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಜಾಸ್ತಿನೂ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು ಕಮ್ಮಿನೂ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು ಒಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಏನಾಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು ಲಾಸು ಸೇಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಇರಬೇಕು ಆ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಶೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ 5,10,000 ಇದೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಶೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ 5,10,000 ಹಿಂಗೆ 1,50,000 ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರು ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರು 3,50,000 ಟೋಟಲ್ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 5,10,000 ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಇರೋದು ಎಷ್ಟು 40,000 ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಪೇ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಾಗುತ್ತೆ 4,70,000 ಈ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಲಾಸ್ 4,70,000 ಎಷ್ಟು ಜನ ಇಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಬೇರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು 8,000 ಫಸ್ಟ್ 2,000 ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 6,000 8,000 ಶೇರು ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ 58.75 ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ 75-58.75 ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಪೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ 75 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಪೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಆದರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಲಾಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ 58.75 ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಮೈನಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ 16.25 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಪೇ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಅವ್ರು ಎಷ್ಟು ಪೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ 60 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಪೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ನಮಗೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಪೇ ಮಾಡಿ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ 58.75 ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಹಂಗಾರೆ ಅವ್ರು ಎಷ್ಟು ಮಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ 1